Joe McGettigan calls the final accuser, victim number 9. Victim 9 attended the Second Mile camps for a couple of summers. He said this, "It was fun." And then asked, "Did you have occasion to meet the defendant?" And he said, "Yes, in the pool. He was playing with the kids in the pool, and I went over there and started playing with the kids and him. And he started talking to me, asking if I wanted to hang out outside the camp. I gave him my mom's number, he called, and I started hanging out at his house. He was a well-known guy, and he seems nice." He went on to say that the first time he stayed at Sandusky's home was a few weeks after he met him, and he was asked, "Did anything happen that made you feel uncomfortable?" "No," he said. "At first he was nice and stuff. We played games, went to games, and went out to eat." He was asked, "Did he give you any gifts?" "Yeah, he got me a running suit, a racquetball, tennis racket, and some shoes, sneakers." Prosecutor McGettigan then asked, "At some point when you were staying at his house, did he do something to make you feel uncomfortable?" "Yeah. He would go to the bedroom with me and start cracking my back, rubbing me, hugging me, kissing me all over and stuff. I told him to stop." "Did you tell your mom?" "Yeah. I told her he was a touchy-feely type of person, that's all." "What's the first thing he did after he started hugging you?" Victim 9 testified that at first Sandusky would kiss him on the cheeks, then he would kiss him on the lips. He went on to say, "Sandusky started getting physical, had me touch his penis and stuff." Victim 9 testified about Sandusky making him perform oral sex. He said he came in the room, pulled his pants down, laid on top of me, and kind of forced it in. "Did you want him to do that?" "No." The witness is now becoming emotional on the stand, and he's asked, "Did you want to do that at any time?" He says, "No. But what was I going to do? He's a big guy, way bigger than me." He was asked, "Did he ever touch your penis?" He said, "No." "Never?" "No." Victim 9 stayed over at Sandusky's house almost every weekend during this period of time, and McGettigan asked him about having to perform these sex acts. And Victim 9 says, "It happened on some of those occasions." He's asked, "Where did you sleep?" Victim 9 says, "In the basement." Then he's asked, "Did he do anything else to your body?" Victim 9 says, "Yes," and he talks about anal sex. And he says, "I was about 13, 14, maybe 15. Victim 9 then talks about how aggressive Sandusky got. And he said, "He got real aggressive and just forced me into it. And I just went with it. There was no fighting against it." He's asked, "Did you do anything to try and get away?" Victim 9 said, "Yeah, sometimes scream. Tell him to get off me. But other than that, you're in a basement. No one can hear you down there." Victim 9 then talked about the last night he stayed at Sandusky's house. He said, "I called my mom and told her to come pick me up because he was trying to get physical with me, and I'd had enough of it."